Hello, hello everybody. It's 9:39 a.m. Central Time on the 14th of March, 2024. And I've got you on here. I'm going to be making this a quick video, show you the proof that the U.S. government says that radio waves can modify the weather. This is something that was debated for years and was said to be impossible by all the skeptics in the world who said that radio waves, electromagnetic radiation in particular, could not modify the weather. So, I'm going to show you what I found. A website that was put together by NOAA during lockdown. And now it's already been put into NOAA Library Archives. But it was created during lockdown, like 2020, 21. And they created a weather modification portal on the NOAA site for all the companies who currently and in the past have done weather modification projects across the country. These are the private companies that are required to report by law. They have to report. The private companies do. Guess who is exempt? Oh, of course, the federal government, who run all the radar stations and all the frequencies from the FCC for transmission of high power anything over the airwaves. But I'd like to draw your attention to number 8 on the list. There it is. Using lasers or other sources of electromagnetic radiation. If you're a private company doing it. And of course, private companies have to get permission from the government, who uses the towers like the NEXRADs and the microwave towers across the country. So what's electromagnetic radiation? Well, radio waves are a type of electromagnetic radiation with the lowest frequencies and the longest wavelengths in the electromagnetic spectrum. They have frequencies ranging from 3 kilohertz up to 300 gigahertz. Wavelengths from millimeter waves, which we all know about with 5G, up to 100 kilometers long, which is VHF, really high-frequency microwave. All right, long story short, electromagnetic radiation is radio waves. And number 8 on the list that has to be reported by private companies. But guess who runs the electromagnetic radiation spectrum in the country? The federal. And any big frequency projects are going to be done not by private companies. So the private companies are doing the other things that are on the list, including cloud seeding and all those other wonderful things that we know about. Now, if you don't know about the quote-unquote spraying that's being done, you might not know about this. Let me take you over and just show you. I've got a playlist here over on my channel where we sent reporters to the weather modification conferences that the weather modification companies hold with NOAA and the National Weather Service. We recorded. I did Freedom of Information Access request on the U.S. Navy Research Laboratories on HAARP and got the plasma information on generating plasma balls in the atmosphere that are superheated. We've got the National Weather Service on record. We got into a conference and got a face-to-face with the director of the National Weather Service and the director of the Storm Prediction Center, where they denied weather modification is currently taking place. And our reporter had just been to the current results from Idaho, where they were enhancing snowpack and all that other good stuff for water enhancement up in the Northwest. And our reporter had just gone to the conferences where NOAA was giving the presentations. And then the directors saying that it's not happening. They gave you 1970s examples, and you can tell they're lying when they're talking on camera. So this is just something that I just had to show you. In case you didn't know, Europe has built 5 different new HAARP-type arrays. It's working in VHF, very high frequency, like FM, frequency modulated, like 200 FM plus. If your car radio could go up to 200 FM, you might even be able to hear it. It would just sound like a bunch of static and fizzing sounds and tweaking and chirping on the radio. But 5 new arrays called ISCAT, E-I-S-C-A-T 3D. So, all right, if you guys want to get up to speed, I'll put the playlist down below. You can go watch it. Again, it's if you want to see the proof of weather modification. It's not up for debate that it's happening. The people who say it's not happening are gaslighting you. They are literally trying to tell you something that's not happening, something that is happening isn't. as you see it happening in front of your face, above you. So anybody who said it wasn't possible to modify the weather with radio waves was incorrect. And I caught so much crap over this. They said there was no proof. This is proof. This is a U.S. government site saying that it's possible. So anybody who said it wasn't possible was incorrect. And so now that we know it's possible, then all the theoreticals that we were talking about that were said to be impossible and conspiracy theories aren't. But I would think it would be a matter of high national security. And that would explain why all the disinfo and denial about it. Because we're talking next level, like right up there with the Manhattan Project, maybe even more. That while, you know, splitting of an atom and a bomb going off in a spot is one thing, but over a vast area of an entire continent, that it would, that weather is even more powerful, which we know it is. So controlling it, this goes into the final part of it that everybody said was impossible. Again, they said it was impossible that radio waves could modify the weather. Here we have them admitting it's possible. That then ties in with owning the weather 2025. Which was a plan put out in the 1990s. Here it is. Archive.org has it, but let's just see if we have weather as a force multiplier from a U.S. government source. Well, here's space.com. Space.com has it. I mean, you can go look it up. Here's National Technology. Here. National NTIS has the document on there. Okay, let's just see if we can. Can we open it up? December of 97. Weather as a force multiplier, owning the weather in 2025. Now, the plan in 1990s was to, this is just a plan, to own the weather by the year 2025, next year. And you can scroll down through it and hear all the proposed processes by which to do that, including radio waves, high-power microwaves, and monitoring the weather changes so that they can influence things real time across vast distances. So you have a huge network that would be involved with doing this. These were the proposals. This is at the time when HARP was built, which HARP has the ability to generate heated plasmas up in the upper atmosphere into ionosphere. Multiple mile wide, multiple kilometer wide plasma balls. And I did a Freedom of Information Access request. We got the actual pictures of the stuff. So in the U.S. Navy document, we've got the actual pictures of the plasma balls, which are actually taken by the U.S. Navy using infrared. Let's see if I can get this in here, if I have this in here, in this video. Well, you guys can go through and watch it again. We're talking hours long watching, but they have diagrams of this. See where it says artificial ionospheric mirror? This is a plasma bubble up in the atmosphere that becomes reflective like a mirror to radio waves. So the plasma reflects radio waves like a mirror reflects light. And so they created and do create superheated areas up in the atmosphere and ionosphere, which then they can use ground-based stations to reflect off and over the horizon over to other locations. But they've also figured out that they can use this for weather modification, which was said to be impossible by all the skeptics who said that it was not possible. Hence my video now. I'm going to put this in the playlist with the rest of the weather modification videos. If you knew anybody who said that it was impossible to modify the weather using radio waves, inverse squares, square inverse, out the window when you start talking about billion watts, trillion watts, and space-based systems. And yes, we are talking billion watts and trillion watts. Trillion watt lasers, talked about Michio Kaku, of all things, on TV talking about trillion watt lasers to modify the weather locally in areas for people to have clear days on their weddings and for sporting events like baseball games. And he said this on CBS's potential uses for the trillion watt lasers that they're developing. I'm just saying that this, when people say that it's not possible, they were wrong, first of all, but they precluded talk about the subject by trying to gaslight you and say that it was not possible. So the people who were trying to shut you up are like these people who previously said something wasn't possible, and it turns out it is possible, and then they don't want to talk about it because it proves them to be complete jerks at best. Scientifically wrong, at best, actually, and jerks or worse, liars in many cases. It was a game to them, maybe. Maybe they treated it like a game. Anyway, weather as a force multiplier was denied as well. They said it was a conspiracy theory. And then when you provide the official government documents on it, they said, it was just uploaded to the government servers. Okay, well, it was put together by the colonel, lieutenant colonels, majors. It was a proposal which was to be done by 2025. And it involves cloud seeding, radio wave manipulation of the weather, global monitoring through weather systems, which they've launched, and that's where we are now. Proof positive right there that you have to keep pushing when people say something, when you know you're witnessing something, and you've got a grip of people that are saying it's not possible while it's happening in front of you, you have to reject what all the people are saying and go against a huge thing, and they'll burn you at the stake every time. Happened to me and every other researcher for the last 15 years as we were trying to tell you guys about it. But as you can see, as stated in Volume 83, Number 19 of the Federal Register, dated Monday, January 19, 2018, that the Department of Commerce and the National Oceanic Atmospheric Administration requires that persons who engage in weather modification activities in the United States shall provide reports prior to and after the activity. And that's for the persons. And if you go read the law, exempt is le gouvernement. And that's all I got to say on that. Word up. Truth will prevail, guys. It'll always come out. Whether it takes a long time, it might take 1,000 years, it'll come out. So what about all must satellites? High-power microwaves can also have the same effect. So it's not just high frequency. It's not just like HARP, but radar itself, 2.7 gigahertz. Musk's satellites, God knows. All the 5G towers. I'm going to tell you guys to look for this. Whenever you see tornadoes, go look on Google Earth or even try to find video of the areas and see how close a proximity to the radar stations and high-power microwave towers you're at. I mean the big ones, the big 1,000-foot-tall towers and the TDWR, Terminal Doppler Weather Radar, and NEXRAD radar stations. You will find tornadoes kicking up over and over again at the 25-nautical-mile range and the 50-nautical-mile range and the 100-nautical-mile range. Go check. Statistically impossible to be chance. Perfectly spaced out at those distances. It's a frequency modulation of the weather. How does that happen? It's a long story, but I can explain that in another video. If you're really curious, I've already explained this many times, how stripped electrons in the atmosphere are invisible. They're electron cascading through the atmosphere in the Earth's magnetic field, and they are proved to have cloud condensation nuclei effect. They can make water molecules in the atmosphere condense. Like a piece of dust, but it's a free ion in the atmosphere, but it's not ionization from radio waves directly. It's from electron cascade as radio waves are converted from AC in the air to DC in the ground. Radio waves get absorbed by Earth's magnetic field. When they get absorbed by Earth's magnetic field, they convert from AC, alternating current, in the air and get taken to ground. And when the magnetic field goes down into ground, it automatically converts in the process called efficiency scaling into DC power. And DC power goes down into the ground from AC radio waves that get absorbed into the atmosphere. They don't just go off into space. Some do, depending on the angle of the transmission, but a lot get absorbed by the Earth's magnetic field and taken down to ground. But that cascading effect, that absorption from translating from radio wave to DC power, electron cascade forms water molecules, CCN, cloud condensation nuclei, the same thing they spray to try to get. They'll try to spray silver iodide to condense water molecules in cloud condensation nuclei. Dust and so forth, Mother Nature does it with dust as it gets blown up into the upper atmosphere and ice crystals condense around those small particles of dust. So they found out it can be done with radio waves. CCN itself, cloud condensation nuclei, plus the heating and rotation that happens with the plasmas in the upper atmosphere and ionosphere high aloft. Crazy. The fact that it was denied, though, while I was doing the research and all these top professors and all these people came stepping and tried to stop the research, really suspect on that. You got to go back and look at the people who did that. The professors, I remember their names. I mean, professors, top skeptics, all these people showed up trying to stop my research as I was doing it. They're publicly accusing me of faking it and wouldn't listen to reason and wouldn't listen to anything I'm posting and try to shut me down, come after my fundraisers and my operation. That was for doing the weather modification research, which they all said was impossible. And now I just showed you, and again, we'll go back and look one more time. They said this was impossible. And this is the NOAA site saying it's got to be reported when it gets done. Private companies aren't going to be doing it, guys. FCC, at least not in the United States. Maybe outside in international waters somewhere, and that's not going to be required to be reported. But if you're high-power microwave, if you're high-frequency, if you're very high-frequency and you're planning on modifying the weather, first of all, you're going to need towers to do it, very powerful in the million-plus watt range, and that means you're going to need FCC approval. And guess what? There's only going to be a few that have it, and it's going to be stuff like this. The 750,000-watt transmitter inside of the NEXRAD radar, for instance. The Klystron inside. When you pulse the Klystron, that has a weather effect. It pulses in high frequency, actually, instead of microwave. It's kind of weird. Okay, anyway, long story. Separate video. Those who just heard what I said, that the microwave radar pulses in high frequency, the Klystron itself pulses all the way out, one big ring around the entire radar instead of a beam coming out when they're tuning it and calibrating it. Unknown mode is what they call it. Unknown mode. Black on the level 3 data, unknown mode, pulsing in test mode. Oh, what about the storms that form and go to the transmitter after that? Oh, man. Don't get me going. The storms form and go to the transmitter, the radio tower that was pulsing to begin with. That's why we see radar station after radar station after radar station and microwave tower after microwave tower after microwave tower have tornadoes form 25, 50, and 100 nautical miles out and then go straight to the transmitter. The tornadoes. Or the storm itself in many cases. Okay. Enough. Why would they do that? Weather control. They don't give a crap about the station or the people there. They're trying to control the weather. Station could be replaced. Cost is irrelevant. You think I'm kidding? I'm not. Word up and much love. Peace out. Be safe. Stick to the truth, and if you find it, don't back down. Ever.